That time of year again, our clock's moving ahead an hour this weekend for daylight saving time. But this week, Congress is also investigating whether it's really necessary to keep doing this year after year and losing that hour of sleep. A recent poll found more than 70% of Americans want to get rid of daylight saving time. This past week, lawmakers debated whether we should move to DST year-round, which would certainly be complicated, no doubt. Of course, Indiana just moved to daylight saving time back in 2006. Complicated in terms of getting all the states on board and doing everything that would have to happen. Well, a former state lawmaker is running for Congress in the 9th District, and recently Erin Houchin sat down with your local election headquarters for a one-on-one interview to talk about her bid to replace current Congressman Trey Hollingsworth, who she ran against in the 2016 primary. This time around, there are even more candidates in that GOP primary.
So in 2016, it was a crowded field. I think having been through that, it made me a better legislator. I think it will make me a better member of Congress. It is a slightly different district, but I think right now more than ever, we need a conservative fighter pushing back against the administration and the policies of the far left. It's what I hear when I travel the district. People care about border security. They care about inflation. They care about supporting our police. They care about the federal government, the state government, keeping mandates at bay, and supporting personal freedom, and that's the kind of candidate that I am.
This is a very divided time, obviously, in our country. We did see some moments of unity during the State of the Union address as the president and the entire Western world really navigates this situation in Ukraine. If you were in Congress right now, what steps would you be calling for in the midst of this international crisis?
You know, it's an international and humanitarian tragedy in Ukraine. I think we certainly could have done more leading up to this to prevent and try to prevent Russia's aggression. It was no surprise when he took that step. We've long known that Putin is a tyrannical thug intent on restoring the former and failed Soviet Union. I think a few missteps that were made along the way, probably chief among them was closing the Keystone Pipeline and stopping oil and gas leases right here in the United States. That now we're spending $75 million a day sending that to Russia for their oil and gas leases. That emboldens that that tyrannical leader into having resources to take aggressive actions against Ukraine. I think we need to stand strong with the Ukrainians and the rest of the international community. It's heartening to see that. It's bipartisan. We saw that at the State of the Union. It was a very bipartisan support for approaches to Ukraine. I just think that we could have done more and should have to prevent this from happening.
Congressional candidate Erin Houchin, thank you so much for being with
thank
us.
Thank you.
We appreciate it. All right, stick around. The panel is back with this week's winners and losers next.